Welcome to another King's Crusher ICC Blitz Banter. Let me just turn the audio off there. Bother me. Okay. Hi on stream. Okay. So I've got a challenge, incoming challenge. It's 9 PM UK time here. I'm going to accept the challenge from Trent David. Okay, I'll try and play a King's Engine. I'll play C5 to make it more dynamic. Benko Gambit territory, I hope. It's gonna be a bit of fun. Maybe I should play the check, could be disruptive. Hi on stream there, by the way. Try and reinforce this. Maybe I should soon play Bishop B7 and E6. And actually, if he takes her, taking might give me the C5 square. And I'm wondering about Knight A6. So this is the first thing, to have the option of A takes. But I'm wondering on takes, actually takes is a bit dodgy. I gotta be careful about this flooding with C5, that's the thing. And also this check might be useful at some point, not here, I mean, not too dangerous. So I'm hoping to continue just with castling now. I'm hoping this dark square play is okay. Takes, I'm not losing the bishop necessarily to the check as knight bd7. I wonder if taking here though. Well, there's knight b3. Maybe in that position there's knight d7. I don't know actually. I think I should probably do it like this. So I'm hitting the rook. If check, I've got knight bd7 protecting a8. That should be okay here, I believe. Now this A file, I'm hoping it's, are we just going to have pieces off? Like the world championship match, like a world championship game. We're just going to take all the pieces off and agree a draw. No, just kidding. No, but I do want to contest this A file. Is that happening? Is he playing E6? E6 looks frightening, actually. Should I have allowed E6? Okay, and get some. I'm hoping to get some dynamic play. It looks a little bit on the scary side. On the bright side of this, I hope there's a bright side. This bishop is activated. I'm wondering about knight c7 hits that pawn. So unless my king's getting slaughtered, this should be, for the moment, this position should. Mind you, queen c6, there's bishop f3. h6, there's queen g6. My king side is under pressure here. I'm wondering, this isn't entirely comfortable. Intriguing. Not entirely comfortable. On the other hand, okay, we are having bits coming off. If I wait for him to take, I have a idea that's a slight improvement. If he takes and I take, that gives my queen the diagonal again and supports rook a8. Here I'd be losing a piece, wouldn't I, if I played this because of the check. So there's a certain amount of pressure here. Yeah, it's looking like an amount of pressure for sure. Um, Can I get a chance to play h6 when I get slaughtered? That's tricky. All right, what do I do? Knight takes. Is my king getting slaughtered? I'm on the knight there. Maybe this is okay. So I can take the knight here. It's two pieces. But I guess my dark squares are weak. Oh, I should have considered knight takes f3. That was rather dumb of me and complacent. Yes, knight takes f3. I was actually, the knight's still handy though for, let's not get mated over here. Can I play this? As long as a8's covered, can I take here and give f7? It is a bit scary. If I can take on e6, then I'll have knight d4. Can I do that? Right, nothing's threatened here at the moment. I assume. Can I just park the queen on f7 to cover e6? Right. King g7. I'm not feeling too terrified. Maybe I should be. But looks as though my position's okay. Except how would I make progress? Can I support e6 with my king? The rook e3 to f3 would be dangerous. Alright, oh, the queen's coming over there. Evict the queen from the back row. I have an exchange of queens. Nope, he's not having that exchange of queens. Okay. What about d5? Okay, let's go back here for a moment. Not really doing anything, am I? Oh, I've just blundered, haven't I? I think he had rook c7. It's a little bit tricky, I've got to say. Oh, knight d4, and I could have played the other knight. I would like to move this knight one day. But, you know, knight d4... Okay. Knight d4 coming up.
Check.
Okay, I think the worst is over. All right, thanks for the game, Chen David. Let's accept from this Mitanov. Take a king's gambit here. Okay, now taking the mistakes of Queen h4, which will be a very short game. I played d3. I think I've played this against them before. Although it's a seemingly modest move, it might give this diagonal later. Did I miss taking a rook in the previous games? I don't know. I was a bit panicky. Maybe I did. Oh, dear. So, this position, that bishop opens up, and there are weaknesses on this diagonal. I'm also hoping this F file will be good later. Okay, so bishop c4, and maybe, well, I'll take it from here. Yeah, it's just from that modest move, it's amazing how aggressive the position can be. Possibly, you know, like this and castling queenside now. I'm not sure I should be worried about bishop f3. Yeah, I think I'm gonna castle. In fact, there's some ideas here. If he castles, of knight g5, and if takes bishop e6, pinning the queen. h6 though is the problem, but I wonder if I can actually just kick this bishop. If it's gonna take, I don't think I mind. Okay, what's happening here? Bishop b5 is an interesting pin, followed by knight d5, knight d5, knight b4. Right, knight takes b5, queen c3. So if takes takes, there's queen c3 after king b7, maybe rook d4 to c4. It looks like a dangerous pin if he's going to play b5. I think I'll take him up on that. Not sure how. I'm not sure how that will go for black. Get the bishop out of the firing line here. Well, okay, here we go. Here we go. I'm hoping this pin is strong enough. I'm just thinking queen c3 maintains the pin for a moment if king b7, and while that's maintained on king, yeah, queen c3, rook d4, and then that's going to be dangerous. Oh, here, okay, this looks like a dangerous scenario now with that pin, that pinned piece. How does black, I don't think black can do too much. Although knight b4, actually, if I took the queen, there's knight takes a2, but simply I'll just take the knight with the queen. I don't think if that's my worst worry, then I just take the knight for knight a2, if I took. But no, I think I'm getting this. Okay, thanks to the game, Nesbitov. J. Russell 2. So J. Russell 2. Actually, why am I pre-moving knight c3? Okay, let's play a grand pre-attack system. This has got something going for it, I think. And we're playing what looks to be a 3-2. It's a 3-2 game. Okay. 3-2 game. So I'll play a grand prix attack. So this system, who was that guy that in the UK that played the grand prix attack? Ah, his name slips my mind for a moment. If anyone on the stream that knows, I mean Rumens, sorry, David Rumens. Yeah, I've video annotated some of his games, David Rumens, and yeah, very interesting. But he's often playing it with the bishop b5, actually, taking on c6, which is more modern treatment of the grand prix attack, when you really want to give up your bishop on c6 quite often. Now here, yeah, black's setup, I thought it was a little bit solid, but not entirely now. That bishop has got great scope here. I'm even wondering, g4, knight takes, rook g1, runs into hassle, right? On the other hand, yeah, I think it's sometimes just good to castle. He's got a check, but I'll move the king. He could undermine the pawns a bit. Okay, I'll go here away from this diagonal. Now, okay, this looks like good position for d5. one potential downside of black's play is me taking off on f6 to weaken d5, but a downside of that is b2. And if I play rook b1 first with the idea of bishop g5, can I have my cake and eat it here? If I just play bishop g5, takes f6, knight d5, but does it actually achieve much? No, I'm not sure now. While I've got d5 under control, I'll do this. Try and undermine black's control of d5. And also g6. Okay, let's let's go crazy. Let's go crazy. So h4, knight h7. g5 hg, hg, knight g5, bishop g5, queen h5 after. I think I need a rook involved before I go completely mad. I suspect it'd be nice to have the rooks involved, but there is knight h7. Oh, I thought I had that under control. That's a shock. There's the bishops here. I thought I had that one under control. Okay. What's the idea? If I play knight e4 or h4, I'm wondering, to test this, knight h7. In knight h7 case, haven't I got, okay, hasn't done that. I'm just wondering this position, if I get a good attack going, although the pawns are vulnerable. I do wonder about queen g4 here. Ah, what's going on here? Intriguing. Okay, so this bishop's locked in at the moment. Knight h7. I think g6 is possible. Because if it takes this d6 check, winning the bishop on e7. That looks dangerous now, black. On knight f6, again, I think I'm going to take here and d6 check.
Check.
Okay, no, he's avoided the dread of d6 check. There's queen h5, though.
Check.
And maybe d6 there, there's knight takes. Oh, d6 check here. Oh, this is looks fatal. There's king f8, there's queen f7. Yeah, it looks fatal. Bishop e6, I'm just going to take. Okay, thanks to the game, J. Russell. Right. So, is it time for an auto-pairing game? Let's play on the 5-minute auto-pairing. There's no challenge at the moment. No unique challenge. Let's play on the auto pairing. From Italy, right? So a king's engine defense. Play a king's engine defense. And try and hammer the dark squares here. I can. In fact, I'm going to play this, but takes check. That little trick is possible here. Knight e4. Okay. Is b5 any good? Let's do this. There's knight e4 and queen h4 check. Little trick. Now, b5 here, I'm hoping to get a load of counterplay. Because he's blocked in his bishop. If he takes here, I'm suspecting. Oh. If I play b4 first, if he takes, he's got queen h6. So knight e4, check, g3. He'll be on d6 after, but, you know, I think that's interesting. I'm hoping it's interesting. You could win d6 later.
Check.
That could be a problem. Not sure how clear this is. Oh, there's knight f6. If we take queen h6, losing the exchange. Ah, losing the exchange here.
Check.
Not entirely clear, is it? The dark square bishop is pretty good. Most likely. Okay, it wasn't the soundest. But I'm banking on the dark square bishop a little bit. Famous last words. Okay, a6 is threatened to trap the knight. I suppose he plays a3. If a6, ab, a3 to try and open up this rook. This looks like a little mistake almost. Oh, f5 is needed. Oh, if I get this out of the way, I can play g5. Which doesn't help at all. No, it does help actually. It protects d6. So let's pin that for a moment. Thankfully, it did help accidentally. Bishop f4. I was just thinking of something else completely different than this position. But anyway. So, is this knight going to be like attack? This is getting a bit dramatic. Ah! I'm stuffed because of that pawn. I'm getting stuffed because of that pawn now. Wow, what a horrible continuation. There's no way back for that pawn. Crikey. Wow. I'm stuffed. I believe he's going to play... This is no way. There's no way I'm holding this.
Check.
So much for trapping the knight. So much for trapping the knight. That's a shame.
Check. I'm
hoping. Oh my god, he's winning the whole bishop now with this move. It just gets worse. It just gets worse and worse. God, what I thought was a safe little tactic in the opening turned into a disaster. I'll play him for a few worthless moves probably. That's unbelievable. The whole sequence there, I thought I was getting the knight, I thought I was getting the pawn. Nothing, it's all gone like completely wrong in this game. It's resignable, yeah, it's resignable. Okay. Nasty one, nasty. Okay, rocky top. I mean, that's something to bear in mind then, that tactic, because I've played that tactic before, usually with good results, but in that position it's a disaster. Yeah. That was such. Oh, I didn't expect that. I have to not play that idea too quickly again without careful checking. Okay. Okay, if I hit e5. Rookie 8 and f6. Try and open up things here. Now, can I take here? He's got binds, but I think I can take things off and protect e6. I hope. So this position. Well, it's pretty solid at the moment. I wonder if I can double on the F-file. Oh, hang on, Bishop D5. There's no pin tactic at the moment. I could more safely. I think this is. I'm hoping it's safe just to play this without any tactic emerging. So if I double rooks and. Okay. If I double rooks. Now, okay, H6, Bishop A6, Bishop A6. What's the point? Okay, I'm on F2 at the moment. All right, Bishop A6 has a point, surely. It's potentially annoying. This is interesting. Now, can I get to play? What can I get to play around about here? Huh. If I treble. Take the queen here. I wonder CD trying to weaken G3. If CD, CD, Bishop F1, if the queen wasn't on G3. Queen's going to go back to F3 for the moment. What's the plan after Queen F3? I wonder. I'll take here and Bishop B4 actually. See where this rook's going. If it goes to C2, then Bishop D3 to F5. If it goes to F2, then what about Queen F6 on D4? Yeah, I think Rook F2, Queen F6. Now, okay, he defends. Actually, I should have. Yeah, Bishop D3 to F5. Is Rook D1 now stops Bishop D3? Okay, let's put this somewhere here. So I want to play at the moment Queen D4 because I'm protecting E6. And okay, can I harass the queen there with E5? There's always takes. I have to move my queen first. Okay, intriguing. Queen F7 would threaten E5 hitting the queen. Oh, that knight's holding up things. Let's kick this knight away from G3. Or just take it. Taking check looks dangerous all of a sudden. Or yeah, Queen F4 looks like splat there. No, except there's rooks on there. Let's not go crazy. Unnecessarily. Not go completely crazy. Is there a simple way of playing this? E5. You can take that. I'll prepare E5 because there's that pin. Takes. Actually, I'm not sure that does anything. Let me see. Oh, the rook's kind of trapped, isn't it? Oh, I'm gonna lose the exchange here. It's Bishop H3, aren't I? This is horrible. Okay, It's a forced loss of the exchange. In fact, there's knight e3, even worse. Oh, this has gone well, hasn't it? Okay, I'm just losing a rook now out of this. Fantastic. Losing a rook. What's the best thing to do here? Apart from resign. Let's try and complicate things. Found a way of losing a rook. That's really quite an achievement for the position I had. Get a pawn here. What a muppet. But I'm talking about me, not my opponent. What a muppet. How did I lose a rook? How? How on earth could I have lost a rook? But anyway, I'll get over it. Hold on a sec. There might be some tricks.
Check.
With bishop e2. He's in time pressure. He's in big time pressure. There's bishop e2 and queen e5. Right, bishop e2. Holding f3. I'm going to take it here and take it here, maybe. Try and get some material back. It's not allowed queen h6. This is better than allowing queen h6.
Check.
Okay, there's got back on the clock there. Okay, Purcell. Hi, Purcell. That was... what happened there to me? I thought I was okay, and then I ended up getting into a mess tactically. What a bunny. I'm talking about myself being a bunny. It's a term in the UK, bunny. So, question on stream. When I played Fiona, I played Fiona. I talk about Fiona, the chess Fiona. Played her once, just friendly game, and it was I think it was a Vienna game. I was playing white. She played e5. It was a quick draw. It was only a friendly game. It wasn't like a serious rated game or anything. And we just had a draw. I think that was it. Okay. If there's any other questions on stream, just let me know. Okay. Okay. Bishop d7, queen c8. The funny story with we had Fiona once for a home match, and no one had the keys, so we managed to default against one of the teams we had a chance of winning. So that was hilarious as well. So we ended up getting relegated again. We go between Division 1 and 2 all the time in the Middlesex League, and it's crucial to win the games you can win, otherwise you end up getting relegated. Because actually, there's one team which hires GMs, literally IMs and GMs, like Hawkins, Hendon, which I don't know if they hire, but they have like GMs playing for them, and they're pretty good. So g3 is, there's a check, king g7 maybe for g4, or h5 for g4. So yeah, to be honest, I had a tough time on Thursday just gone. I had a club match, and I haven't done the video yet, but it wasn't too pretty, because I lost basically and couldn't sleep much after. But I find doing post-mortem analysis helps to be able to sleep like 2 days after. So okay, I'm gonna get mated here if I'm not careful, and there's also knight f3. At the moment, no. Okay, at the moment I'm gonna risk this, because I'm hoping this isn't winning, because unless knight e4 to like hit the knight, and so I don't know. It's, my over the board games are far more painful than anything online, actually, because the amount of time invested, and then if you like, you know, mess up a better position, it's more painful, all that time investment and stuff. But no, I think the experience was overall fun. It's But yeah, I need to get in better shape for the over the board season. It's not, I'm not in great shape at the moment for the over the board season. It's just, but anyway, I think that's actually it's also happened before that. I feel I need to play more precisely and more d deeper plans and deep downsides, finding the downsides of the opponent's play. It's too shallow blitz usually for over the board like standards, the same kind of approach, a slightly different ball game. Now here, by the way, I'm closing up the position. I'm gonna have zero like winning chances at this rate. I mean like zero. So and the knight wants to go to f5. All right. I mean basically, is it zero or is there anything? I can get a knight to g6 later. I'm hoping I can get a knight to g6 later to win h4, so I'll keep this closed, this position. My plan is a knight to g6, and I can get like this there. Actually, it's not totally beyond reach, potentially, especially if he plays like that. This is one pawn, I think, which is a downside of the opponent's position. Yeah, after every over the board game, I delve into my philosophies and stuff, and I don't know, this thing about I had a clock advantage by about 20 minutes, and I think one thing is just to somehow make use of that if you've got a clock advantage, which is usually the case if you're a blitz fanatic, then how do you actually use it? Like so probably a deeper kind of search for the flaws of the opponent's position. It sounds good to me at the moment, which I didn't like do. And I don't know, I can only try and I'm yeah just try and get better for other games if possible. So knight g6 takes. I mean, this was my idea to try and win this pawn, but here is it totally dangerous? It is, isn't it? Rook d7, king f6, there might be e5. Oh, he's going for that one. All right, rook h5, there might be knight e5. If rook g5, yeah, king f6, he's always got check and check here. And what if I took the rooks off? Would I have any winning plan after that? I think the knight could probably be tricky there, so I think that might be enough to take the rooks off. Okay, so there's the knight's gonna hop in somewhere, but where? Maybe it's worth like checking out where. Knight d3, and then what? Nope, nothing. C4 first. Okay. F5 takes king f6, bishop c2. That might be a start, actually, just the sack of pawn. I'm wondering, because I think the bishop will be overloaded because knight c2, knight b2. I'm hoping the bishop's. Oh, he's not even doing that. Okay. Well, there's f3 check takes g2, almost working. F3 check. If the king was a bit further, this might work. G2, but there's king f2. On c4. On c4. Well, here, f3 does work for g2. It's too far away, that king. Okay, thanks for the game there. A4 H5. And thank you guys for saving me from the wrath of the auto pairing. A little bit. I know some of you are really dangerous as well though. I'm not saying that you're all bunnies for the bunny boiler, but it's the auto pairing can be totally like vicious here. Because great credit to the ICC's strengths, like GMs, IMs, blah blah blah, etc. So okay. Now, just in case anyone's wondering, yeah, I think the term bunny is a UK term, and it's not really, I believe, equivalent to fish in the US, because I think fish is a little bit on the negative side. When I talk about bunny, it started with friends playing blitz chess, and really we just call each other bunnies all the time, you know, and crushing bunnies, and a lot more phrases related to bunny and etc. Yeah, it's not meant really in a negative way, more of a jestful way. So it's like, it's not really literally translated into anything like that other word, just for information. Okay, so queen f2, then maybe b4 at some point, except c3, it like falls apart. Okay, this, I don't want to play this because of knight f5. If I play bishop g1 here, I think that's probably the safest bet right now. Keeps that pin on the c pawn, keeps some flexibility of pawn structure. I don't really want a blockading knight on f5. This bishop, can it pop out for a bit? I'm not dropping f4 at the moment. Okay, and what about rook ae1? Does that look as though my bishop's going to get killed? Probably. I don't like this b-file either, actually. That's emerging. And also the pressure on c3 is unpleasant. Oh, I thought you could have taken with the b-pawn. That seemed fairly unpleasant. Now, okay, I can stop at an entry point with bishop e3 for a moment, just in case d2's a problem. Can I blunt his bishop by giving him the d5 square? That would be a major concession. What about g4 instead? g4 trying to blast out with the light squares. He's giving some solidity away with that move as well. So I'm wanting to tap into this a bit further, this aspect of king safety. This diagonal might be weak later or pretty soon. And if I doubled on the G file and maybe played rook h3, I might bring something up. Well, I have to unpin in any case if I want to play e takes at some point. Now, rook g1, rook h3. Am I up to anything naughty? Maybe my opponent is, but I can play f5 here, trying to undermine maybe d5. Nice pin, takes. That's a nice pin, but I'm pinned here as well. I'm wondering about rook g7 in that position. Takes, check, king moves, then what? Is there anything? Not entirely sure. Yes, this point of equilibrium, takes. I'm pinned with that pawn, he's pinned with the knight. Do I get to do anything in regards to king safety? Tricky. I could double the rooks, that's what I could do. Right. Oh, I don't like this. After that, my position doesn't look too stable. If I took here, this doesn't look ideal. I'm going into a pin, aren't I? Voluntarily. Okay, I can at least play this to avoid losing a pawn, I think. Is there... Okay. Not ideal from what I had. I thought I had some sort of something going on, but not now. If I get a position where I can play g5 without losing, maybe that's possible, because bishop h6 after is bishop f2. I'm wondering, takes takes, bishop h6, bishop f2 is possible there, not g5 takes on g5, but bishop f2. Just want to unpin. Okay, let me unpin. As long as I don't go on a dark square, there's rook e3, bishop h6. Maybe h4 is worth playing at some point. So this ending, rook d8, bishop d4.
Check.
Right, stay on the light squares for a moment, because king g3, bishop e5. Yes. Ah, that is a good point. And what if I go to, if I went here to e2 instead? There is this for bishop h6, maybe h4, if bishop h6, g5 on rook e8. Doesn't have d4 immediately. Bishop f6, all right, takes, actually is g5, so rook e8 takes bishop h6, g5. All right, the pressure's on here. All right, I'll take this guy. Now, yeah, I'm getting exactly nothing at the moment. On g6. Maybe rook c6 is on a light square. Okay, he's going to play bishop d4 if I'm not careful. So I go here. I'm looking at the forcing moves. I could take here. Then I end up losing a piece. Now there's rook d6 after. To stop bishop d4. So I've nicked a pawn, basically. I've actually taken a pawn. Bishop c5 is around the corner. Can I play the check? Bishop c5 was around the corner. I've also got rook d5 if rook e7. Then he plays like c3. Okay, a rook c7. Just to stop bishop c5. Try and arrest this pawn before it's a nuisance. Alright, there's no bishop c5 at the moment. Can I play g5 and try and get my pawns going before it's too late? Oh, there's bishop f4 on the way. I have to stop bishop f4. I'll be able to play rook f3. I need my pawn to counterbalance here. Yeah. Oh, hang on, there's a check. And this might save my bacon. Except it doesn't. If I take, check, takes. Yeah, king d3. Yeah, maybe.
Check.
Because this pawn, how does he get round to his past pawn?
Check.
Alright, thanks for the game there, A4 H5. Nick and Wildo, I can't pronounce your nickname, sorry. Let's play an Alkyne defense. I've had this position before. It seems on the comfortable side. White's playing a really good setup here. I think I've seen Karpov play this. Really good setup for White. Is the idea d5 here against this setup? Because otherwise, I think that I've had this before where. Maybe he could have taken that pawn. If I do this. Is it completely terrible for me, or slightly terrible? If I played e6 and knight e4. Try and use the g-file later. King H8 and Rook G8. All right, so King H8 and Rook G8. Yeah, if B5, Knight A5 to C4. In fact, here, idea of Knight B4 is attractive. Just B5, Knight B4. In some respect. I think Rook G8, Bishop F6. Or Bishop F6, Rook G8. Okay. If I take on A2 and Bishop F6. Rook G8, Rook G7. Alright, I think I want to take that. So runaway pass pawn. So if I played Rook G8 here, he's got this pass pawn as well. Am I going to get any counterplay over here? Okay, so Rook G6, Queen G8 to G7. Is he going to use that C8 square soon? Maybe King G7, just get my king off the back row. It's a bit safer, because this infiltration is potentially nasty. He's got the 2-1 pawn majority. Yeah, this looks a little bit on the nasty side. This pass pawn over here. I'll try for queen b4, but I think it's just queening. I can't let this pawn go any further. What about bishop d8 to b6? If I play bishop d8 here. This, my knight, my rook is in a terrible place as well. If I can blunt with knight c4. We'll challenge that knight on e5. Now I'm just losing the exchange here. It's bishop g5. Pretty much doomed. This position is doomed, isn't it? I'm just losing the exchange. Bishop g5, yeah. It's pretty hopeless. Let's play one or two more moves. I think it's totally gone. Yeah, that whole g-file plan was terrible in retrospect. And he's winning. Is that more precise or something? Is that more precise? Oh my god. Alright, maybe f3. Knight c4. He's always got b6 as well. b6, b7. Just to seal the deal. Or takes and then b6. Yeah, I give up here. Okay, that was unfortunate. Okay. Ouch. All right, there's no, oh. Let's play a 5-minute water pairing. There's no other unique challenges. Okay, werewolf on the 5-minute water pairing. So Tarash. This. I'll try and get rid of his light square bishop with a5 and b6 for bishop a6. Then squeeze the queen side, I think. b5, b4. Right, so b4 coming up, maybe actually king over here. And then play for b4, I think. So I think b4 could be interesting. Unless f6 is worth considering. Don't know. I'll try this. Okay, this downside is g7 immediately. e6, I'm hoping there's no queen sack on e6. Oh, you can just take on e6. Ah! You can just take on e6! What am I doing? Yes, dodgy. You can just castle. Let's use this f file for a moment. If only this wasn't checked, there might be knight d4 if that wasn't checked. Just losing all these pawns now. Open up here. Can't take there without losing f3. I'm just wondering to open up. e6 is... Yeah. Trying to get some sort of stuff going on if I can, but it's looking more and more unlikely at the moment. I'm getting stuff like a turkey, which is topical for Christmas. So, okay. Yep. This looks like it's not great. Is there potentially bishop c5? That's the only thing I'm thinking. Bishop c5 doesn't really... This has been torn apart because I let e6 go. It's grovelly. d5, bishop c5, and rook c8. And then g4 at some point. I don't know if I should have too much optimism here, because this looks really strong generally. Unless I'm getting his king somehow, which looks unlikely. This is all falling apart from the seams from that e6, dropping e6. So I can't play even rook c8 without knight d6 check. I can play g3, maybe. Oh, that looks wicked. Haven't got any response here to this idea of b5, have I? This looks really bad. I mean, seriously bad. Yeah, there's no response here. There's no response. Yeah, I'm trapped there. It's gonna win the queen.
Check.
Yep, I'm getting torn apart. That's pretty bad. Okay, I'll try again on the auto pairing. At some point, it should get a bit easier. At some point. Play this bishop g5 line. I usually play with the black side of this burn variation, but let's try it like this. The white side. Although, yeah. Alright, so queen e2. Let's pick for knight g5 hack attack. Play for knight g5 anyway. Could be good for that h file. And there's knight h7, knight f6. Now here, okay. Right. Right, actually, I don't know, the sense might be more important here than anything else. What if I took? What if I took? Because isn't there like knight takes e5 here? His nickname reminds me of dentist a little bit. Dentist chess. If I play g3 and then remember to move the rook, which is now hit. Okay, there's bishop d. Well, there's check if I want to take this bishop on d. If bishop d5, there's a check. Hit the queen. Maybe bishop b3 and e6. Play for e6. E6.
Check.
Alright, so bishop c2. There's going to be bishop d5 if I'm not careful. Not here. The queen's not on e1, so I can play like rook d5 without losing e1. If I can play bishop c2, I can play queen g6. What if I took and then bishop c2, I'll be threatening queen e8. If I take, and then bishop c2 would threaten queen e8. I wonder if he spots the little subtlety here of queen e8 as opposed to queen g6. This does look like a dangerous thing, position all of a sudden. Queen e8. In fact, rook g8, maybe bishop g6 with the threat of queen g8 and rook e8. I don't think. Yeah, bishop g6 on rook g8. Right, stop that e8 square being used. I can threaten mate, like originally mentioned. The rook's hanging, right? So I think this is still promising. I can't use the rook for rook on the 7th, that's queen f1. I'm just wondering, king g8. Oh, has he resigned? Okay, managed to get one back on the auto pairing. Chef cat? Have we played chef cat? Chef cat. Has not. Wait, let's play Shafkat. Hello. Okay, Shafkat. And let's play G3 here. Okay. g3. I'm wondering if this is a good plan. Okay, can I play this? So c3, b4, that sort of thing might be fun. I'm hoping anyway, it'll be fun to play like this. Where's that knight going? That naughty knight needs to be punished. Cheeky knight. Where's it going? Okay. That's good news for me, surely. So I can neutralize the bishop. I can neutralize it like this. Actually, winning another piece with a5. That looks good as well. This game goes well so far. But it's not over till it's over. It's not over till the fat lady sings. So queen b3, I think the knight. I could have played rook a7 as well. Wondering about if. Okay. Depending on what he does, I mean, it's looking in good shape, obviously. Okay, very good shape. Okay, thanks for the game, Chef Cat. Alright, no more unique challenges at the moment. So, auto pairing game. Let's shuffle here. This is a mixed shuffle tape here today. Oh, Justin Chess. I don't think we played Justin Chess. Let me just check. I'm pretty sure I haven't played Justin Chess. Okay, try King's Engine. Not that I haven't had much luck earlier with King's Engine, but maybe it's going to change at some point. Bishop d7 for b5. That's sort of standard plan sometimes. Just to try and generate some queenside counterplay. I've got a little earwax problem at the moment. I've got OTAX. I've been taking it the last few days. I'm hoping we clear out at some point. I'll be like Death as Petrosian, which wasn't his advantage in certain key matches. He had this World Championship challenge match where he was deaf to the traffic, apparently. Didn't disturb him at all, but it disturbed his opponent. I'm not totally, there's just a little bit in this ear. It's like when you step from an airplane. So b4, rook b4. This rook, I'm not sure. Yeah, this doesn't look entirely great at the moment. I'm just wondering what he will do. If b4 is ruled out, I could just take that surely at the moment. What will he do here to punish my squishy position? Is there actually an idea of e5 if he's not gonna come up with something radical here? E5, maybe even f5 later. My position will be looking attacking visually anyway. Except I'm giving the d5 square, maybe if he takes that d5 square could be a problem. Is he still connected? It's been a while. This is a big thing for a 5 minute game. Ooh, big thing here. Am I still connected? Oh god, I'm gonna just check. Yeah, I think I'm still connected, right? That was a big thing. Does he take? I don't know. It might activate me if he. All right. Okay. It's looking more aggressive now. I got rook b4. Okay, there's rook b3 maybe. Or am I getting the rook trapped? It's possible. Right, I think the rook needs to move. Out of harm's way. Well, I like my clock advice. You had a deep think. Deep think. F4, G5 coming up. And so G5, H5, Knight F6, G4. Looks like a typical King's Indian attack is brewing. Potentially. I'll ignore that for the moment. Okay, is there Bishop A4 for Rook B1? I'm hoping there is. Takes, take here. Takes my queen, takes bishop. Oh. No, I might have had this slightly wrong. Nevertheless, it's not too terrible. Play for G4. Right. Is rook f6 possible? Well, there's bishop e5. If I took here, queen d6. If I queen d8. Right, if I. Okay, queen d8. Maybe. I need to get some tactics with rook g6. Alright, it's knight e4 check, friend. I'm still knight e4 for rook c6.
Check.
That's good news, I think. There's F3 here. There's a check here, or bishop H6, maybe.
Check.
Hit this bishop. I don't want to lose the bishop. Hold on. How dangerous is this? Can I play here? Oh, good. Got to unpin quick. Well, this is a disaster.
Check.
Is the 96?
Check. 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 Check.
tens.
Check. Check. Check.
Have I got no interesting checks here? Or Queen G3. Trying to double attack his pieces for a moment.
Ah,
oh, that has done the job. Okay, tough one there. Fence doesn't just. That was pretty dramatic. Yeah, I think. Right, 5 minute auto pairing. Queen takes h7 mate. That's one of my favourites on h2. Okay, I played into a winnower, which I don't really like. Forgotten I don't like the winnower, but anyway. Maybe this one is a difference from the winnower. It's slightly interesting.
Check.
And make it some sort of gambit. If he plays f5, f3, some sort of gambit. I think it might actually have a name, which adds great credibility to playing it. Maybe. F5, F3. I'm hoping that this is okay. Just take the pawn back. Now, just take the pawn back. And protect her. Alright, so bishop d3. I don't want to have my. I'm not getting my bishop trapped, am I? f4, I need to give my bishop a reverse gear. So he's got d2. He's pushing a lot of pawns here. But. Yeah, scary. Mind you, bishop d3. I've got weaknesses to probe, surely. Did I just play an inaccuracy again? Okay, if I play the check and go back again to protect d4, this is awkward. I wonder if it's safe to castle. Will I get hit with f3? Maybe g3 and bishop drops back to f1 if I ever got that far. Pardon me, pardon me. Okay. Scary. But okay, let's go with this. Because I'm hoping for bishop f1 to avoid getting mated at some point soon. So rook e1. Bishop moves. This bishop's stuck, actually. This isn't entirely a clever position, but anyway. Rook e1. Queen d3. Queen e4. Bishop d3. Maybe that sort of arrangement. Oh, has he got bishop f5? Yeah, that sort of arrangement. Bishop f5, queen f3. Okay, I'll stop that. We'll give the bishop. I'm going to give the bishop g5. Just to hit the queen. Now. Okay, I'll take on. I'm going to get mated. I'll just push them to mate me. I'm going to take on d5 though. If he takes on f1, I can take on f3. If he plays there, I've got bishop f3. Alright, got to be careful about getting mated. Well, there's king h2 now, if queen e7. Try not to get diabolically mated. Oh, I am. It's happened. Oh, what? Muppet. I was trying to avoid getting mated. And I'm getting mated. Oh, jeez. That is just sad. That is just sad how I've ended up in this. Oh, man. Ah, weakened light squares. King G1, Queen H3. Oh, okay. Jerome. Let's try Coracon. Okay. This is often liable. Take Queen e7. It's fairly solid at the moment.
Check.
Maybe Queen h4 is interesting. Try and generate some weak spots. Yeah, there's always knight g5, queen f5. Queen f5 may be sufficient on knight g5. Quick queen f5. Okay, so. Knight c5 protects b7 for a moment. Well, it does run into bishop d4. That might not be entirely clever. Probably best to lose. Yeah. Have to lose this pawn, I think, on b7. I think I can crawl back a little bit if plays like d6 takes. Knight c5. Bit of piece play. Right, is that f6? Right, if I take hitting the rook, that might be good news here. Takes, can't take here. Rook f1, if he takes for the rook. Maybe just rook f5. I think rook f5 was rook h4. Trapping the queen. This queen trap, I've got to be careful of. Gonna take that, but I can't play rook f5, I believe. G5? What about g5? I have queen g4, there's rook f1. I want to play rook f5 to double the rooks. I might have something going on here if I can get to play rook f5. Let's hit this rook for a moment. And avoid the checks, actually. I'm gonna keep the rooks on. If he takes here, okay. Okay, rook g4 for rook f3. Might be interesting. Okay, I'm hoping to double the rooks. Oh, queen h3, come on, queen h3. Oh, why didn't I play queen h3? Muppets. That would have been good.
Check.
Yeah, that got him because of the mate. What goes around comes around. Okay, does the Master of Disaster. I don't think we've played Master of Disaster tonight. Okay, Master of Disaster. 10:27. Okay, time now. 10:27. So I've been bruised, battered and bruised tonight. Otherwise I would make it a 10-hour session, yeah. If only I could win every game, but if I could win every game, chess wouldn't be worth playing. It'd be like noughts and crosses or something. It's only because chess is a wicked wicked game. Okay. H4, knight g5. He's just gonna try and I don't know. Okay, so try and enjoy it. Okay, whatever happens. So g4, knight g5. As with everything. Okay. Bishop g6 coming up. But there's nothing like the auto pairing if you really want a strong blitz venue. It's the place.
Check.
The ICC auto pairing in general. Okay, so here we go. King displaced. I can win g5, which I know my king's on that g file, but this looks interesting. I'm hoping more for the opponent's king. Actually, okay, yeah, this looks good. Okay, so there's knight e6 here. And maybe queen d3 for queen f5 is on the cards. On knight h6, there's bishop f4. So I'm thinking to play queen d3 if given the chance.
Check.
Oh, I might get mated on h4 if I'm not careful. Small safety point. If queen h4, I'll get mated. Okay, so I better be careful on that. This isn't entirely without risk, this position. Is bishop f4 remove if he moves his queen? I take then I think I'm gonna have to punt bishop f4. Any like king g6, queen d3. My king's safer anyway, it controls h4, the rook. King g6, queen d3. And then what? I'm sure the black king's not too happy there. This position. Again, queen d3. Check. King's not entirely happy. Wants to play queen h4 to terminate me. That doesn't terminate me immediately, but anyway, I've got to keep the checks going. King f7, bishop g5, double check. Clearly they should play the King's Gambit in the World Chess Championship. That's what's missing. Okay. King's Gambit. It's not gonna happen. It's too unsound for a World Chess Championship. Except if we went back in time to like the 1900s. Maybe. Okay, so Bishop G5. Check.
Check.
And I get nothing from that check. Nothing. Nothing. Not a sausage. Not a sausage. Ah, why did I play that check? What am I thinking? So Queen F5, Bishop D5 is possible almost. I wonder if he'll play it. I'll play this anyway. It looks like a load of pressure if he doesn't play Bishop D5. I have to think about this. Well, there's Knight C7. I think it's sufficient, the pressure here with Knight E4. Bishop D5, Knight F6. Yeah, the pressure's massive. If I can play Knight E4 on this F file. So Knight E4 is coming over, I think. Aha! I think Knight E4. Aha! And if I cement the center for a moment, just so there isn't Bishop D5. Aha! Bring everything together over here. Oh, that looks a little bit on the
check.
Desperate side.
Check.
Well, there's a check,
check.
Here. And does this lead anywhere?
Check.
And take out this bishop here, because it is threatening my king safety. And pin again, pin and win. And can I more pressure on f6 with rook f2? Okay, now this is not perpetual or a mate, I believe, at first
check.
Sight. Okay, thanks for the game there. Okay, a 5 minute auto pairing. Troll bets. Let's play an English opening. Pin 95. And what's good here? E3, G3, B4. I don't even know. Actually, I'm not entirely sure. B4 is a good idea. But anyway, it's happened. It's going to be a pawn sack or something. Okay, interesting position alert. Is there c5? Just trying to break his pawn structure down. Yeah, it's hitting d6 and e5. This could be funny. If I want a centre pawn here. Okay, looks interesting, intriguing. And queen here for knight f7. Or knight d6 check for queen f7. Wow, there's some possibilities here on f7. They're not mating or anything. Qe4 knight d3. Right, Qe3 though. What is it, Qe3? I'm wondering about AB. F4 for F5? Is that too radical? Or G4 for G5? Or G3? Maybe G4 is interesting. Or just G3? Forcing moves of interest, knight F7. Probably G3. And bishop c5, there's d4. It takes, I'll play bishop c3 just to have d4 there. If it's bishop e7, bishop g2, I think it's an interesting position. Oh, don't tell me I've been disconnected. No, I'm still kind of just wondering about why his clock stopped. Why is his clock stopped? Okay, it started again. I don't know if he's got a bad connection. What's happening here? Okay, so bishop g2. Oh, I'm just run into that. This might not be at all clever. Doesn't look clever anymore. Okay, bishop g2 and castle. I haven't got any threats here of great interest. I guess I could consider using the h pawn. He could play like this. Bishop g2 and f4 if he plays like that. Take on a3. b5 rule out. I suppose f6 is a major concern. This pin generally. Knight d3. This looks interesting. Is that d5? Bishop h3 for knight e6. Maybe 96 preparation with this.
Check.
Oh, is he taking that? Ah! Right, there's rook d8 check.
Check.
There's a check here, hold on.
Check.
This looks like good news. Queen e8 or queen h7.
Checkmate.
Ooh, okay. That's a bit of luck. Yeah. I thought the opening was interesting. Oh, this guy, he's Speedy Gonzalez. I don't know if any of you remember on the channel, played Woodpusher before, and it was like Speedy Gonzalez time. This guy's super quick and reasonably accurate. Very, very dangerous, I think. I think I've actually just got two nil against me. Unfortunately, I haven't even got a good position. I mean, I had a great position once against him, and just got slaughtered in time pressure. I think he might have to be wary for at some point knight g5, but not here. This is a very dangerous opponent. Can I try and trap his bishop, I wonder? To stop bishop f5 and knight d2. No, he's always going to take my bishop. Can I have the c4 square? D5 will drop. Can I do anything about this? If I play knight d2 here to avoid bishop g2. So I'm threatening knight d2. And it gives his bishop way back. I've given him the e5 square on a plate, haven't I? Essentially. This e5 square, I know it looks awkward this, but I've just given him e5 on a plate. Oh, don't tell me knight g5, it's going to weaken my e5 with knight g5. Takes. Maybe it's not sufficient. Do I get to play e5? Well, that's a little bit interesting. I just remember last time I played him, he just went ballistic on speed after. I had a really good position in this other game as well. This is starting to look like a good position. But I'm not counting any chickens in this game. It looks as though it's squished, doesn't it? Bishop e5, I'm just going to sack the exchange. Bishop d4, king h1. Do not count any chickens against this guy. Hold the d4 square. I'm ready for an exchange sack. If he wants to play bishop e5, I'm ready for it. I'm just going to take on e5. Knight d6 is a trap. Check. He's got a check. Oh, what have I gone into now?
Check.
Oh, gold. I lose my queen on king f2. I lose the exchange on the other one. That's nice.
Check.
I'm hoping it's not the end of the world just yet, but it's not nice to miss moves like that. Have I got g5? Was there bishop e5? I have to play this. There's 97. I take. Oh, there's a check here. Bishop h2. Play 97 first. King h7, rook e5. I can play 97 first.
Check.
This check is really dangerous. And rook f8 is really dangerous. I think this plays check first.
Check.
Then rook f8.
Check. Check.
Check. Yeah, it's too good. I've got a very bad record against them. Extremely bad. Okay. Let's have one more, I think. I can fit in one more. I mean, he has that before. I have a seemingly crushing position. And I don't know, it just falls apart. But anyway, but I had much, yeah. Okay, anyway. I mean, what's it? Okay, maybe a couple of 3 minutes. Let's have a 3 minute. GM, Eurofighter, plan knight c6, French. Couple of 3 minutes. I don't want this knight g5 line particularly to hit me too hard. Although this is a bit silly with knight c6, I want to say. But anyway. There you go. Okay. I'm going to leave g4 unattended. Okay. h3 g3 at least. And there's bishop a6. Try and make something out of this. If I can weaken these light squares, maybe even get the queens off here. I'm Maybe c5, knight c6. I get squished with f5, f6. Does that kill that? My king can. Maybe I can play. I can play that position or not. I mean, knight here is better. Nope. Okay. Okay, it's going to be fun.
Check.
Oh, not the e6 pawn dropping again. That is a disaster when that happens. Not the bleeding e6 pawn dropping. No. The only thing is, it's a 3-minute game. There might be more chaos available than usual. Otherwise, it is pretty doomed. Hoping a bit more chaos. Is this possible? To play knight b6 is pretty terrible, but no. Yes, any move. Okay, that's not mate. I thought that was mate for a moment. It's not mate yet. Okay. And he's got a low rating for a GM. Maybe he's slow. You never know. Okay. It's 97, but this is looking as though e7 is too strong. e7. Okay, I'll take it here first. I mean, he's got e7. He's got everything he wanted from this game, unfortunately. With me falling apart at the seams. What he hasn't got is bags of time. Okay, he hasn't got knight d6 either immediately. Okay, losing the exchange isn't my biggest issue here to worry about. It's his 20 seconds if he doesn't speed up. C takes. Okay, knight d6. Knight d6, there's rook e7. There's ab. This is falling apart totally at the seams, yes. Okay. Okay, hang on, there's b2. Hold on. Spend some time there.
Check. 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 Check.
I'm going to keep the checks up, basically.
Check. Check.
Draw.
Check.
Yes, sorry, it is a 3-minute game. There's one more to fit in. It is a 3-minute game. He did have a low rating. I think the performance rating here is not an indication of his fantastic ability. It's just, I think he's got a slow connection or something. But I hate being dismantled from e6. That's a terrible pattern to have, this dismantling on e6. By the way, these are 3-minute auto pairing ratings. You might find them a bit weird. There's a different rating again from the 5-minute auto pairing. Right, he's taking his time for a 3-minute game. I'm getting happy with the position here. I'm not sure he knows what he's doing at all in this. There's bishop h6, for example. This looks like absolute murder. Rook f7, queen g6. This is, looks absolutely murderous, but ef. Let's try and find the best way. Well, I'm on the rook here. Let's win the exchange.
Draw?
No, I'm not accepting the draw here. I'm threatening rook f8 now. Rook g5. It's rook d5 for bishop b3. Opens up this diagonal. If he misses rook d5, there's bishop b3. Well, that changes the picture there, unfortunately. But, okay, if I just take here on bishop b3, so I'm on d5 anyway without any sack. Without risking any check. Pretty solid center. Bishop d5 here, he hasn't got time for any check. I can take the queen. There's knight e2 check. Should I be worried?
Draw.
I think I'll draw again. Wow.
Check.
Is the knight trapped? I just go here? Where's the knight going? H1? King G1? Very seriously, this game.
Draw.
Check.
Oh, rook f3 might have been worth considering. This is still, I think, good for me. Potentially. Although it's got mega complicated out of nothing.
Check. Check.
And now I've just lost it. Oh my god, I've just lost it. I've just lost the game. I can't believe it. I can't believe I lost this game. I can't believe it. I've just been swindled. Totally.
Time warning.
Totally. Queen G1, check. Yeah. He had Queen check. G1, mate.
Check. Check.
That was incredible.
Check. Check.
Absolutely, I mean, incredible. I really thought I had it in the bag. Okay, a great way to end. Unbelievable, unbelievable. I just thought it was just all over. It was just, I got it wrong. I thought it was all over. Very resourceful play anyway. Well played. Zoom. Okay, I think I'm ending it here. Okay. Jeez. Okay, anyway, great way to end, but it's kind of getting late now, 11 o'clock. All right, thanks for coming. The 3 minute is pretty tough as well. Oh, blimey. Okay. I'll just check. Okay, thanks for coming, and maybe see you next week then. Okay, cheers then.